Welcome back and happy new year from Calhoun County's Most Wanted. I'm your host, Chris Fried, along with Chief Deputy John Garlick. It's weird getting
it's
used
weird
to the
new year. Yeah.
Things are changing.
Things are changing everywhere. Right. It's wonderful. We're making all kinds of changes at the office, too.
Yeah, renovations are going on right now. How's that going?
Oh, my gosh. It's going really well. We've got I think we've had it on Facebook, our new squad room, new paint scheme, new floor, sturdy floor instead of carpet. New desks and workstations for the guys that are in there, and we're kind of carrying that theme on to other offices in the main sheriff's office. Then once we finish that, it's into the jail and clean that place up. And we've got lots of storage problems, though. We're running out of storage space, so we're going to come to your house with all of our old files.
Yeah, I got plenty of room at my house. Bring it on.
We're going to fill it up there, and then we're going to go to your cabin.
I've been spending too much on energy costs here with the cold weather, so bring it on. Yeah, I need something to burn to keep us warm. Oh, so. But actually, speaking of that cold weather, how did we do with the ice on the roads here over the last few days?
It was a pretty hairy Friday. The roads really became very dangerous, and thankfully the timing was much better with this storm than it was for the one a couple of years ago. Mm-hmm. Schools were closed, people were already home when the roads got bad, but they stayed pretty bad, and a lot of roads were closed Friday night, most of the day Saturday, and then roads, because of travel, opened up and were safer on Sunday, and then of course by Monday, we're over.
Not completely over. My kids were still at home on Monday.
I'm sorry.
Their school was still closed for the entire day on Monday because up on the hill and they still had some ice. Henry Road was closed, so you couldn't get to the Donahoe School. But it just amazes me that we keep talking about how fast the polar ice caps are melting, but the ice in Anniston just wouldn't melt.
Well, snow and ice emergencies in the South are usually pretty transient. They come and they go within 24 hours. This one lasted for 3 days or better.
But the public on the road, how did we do?
They did well. There were some accidents, a lot of accidents on I-20, but around the county, there weren't a lot of accidents. People were pretty much off the road and stayed safe. So we did a good job. Everybody
stayed home. So B-plus, A-minus here?
Yeah, probably B-plus.
All right, so. And we'll probably have some more opportunities for you to raise your grade, hopefully not lower it later on in the season. So good job. Keep it up. We need to talk about how many folks we've arrested, thanks to our viewers.
Another good job. We had six arrested, up to 3,880 people put behind bars since we started this show.
That is excellent.
That is very, very excellent.
All right. So we will have some more folks that we need your help locating coming up in just a few minutes. And also, the show's just going to the dogs today. You'll find out soon what I mean by that when we come back on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
Look, I got to flee.
Ford brand has always brought you impressive style and legendary quality. And Sonny King Ford brings you the lowest price and the largest inventory, new or pre-owned. The new 2015 F-150 gets the best gas mileage of any truck without giving up its powerful towing capacity. The iconic new 2015 Mustang with its classic pony car looks and hunkered down stance preserves a legacy that defines American motoring. For over 93 years, Sonny King Ford for the best cars and best price.
Amazing grace.
How sweet the sound
that saved.
A crackhead.
Drug addict.
Alcoholic.
Meth freak.
A wretch.
Like me.
I once was.
Homeless.
Broken. Sad.
Just lost.
But now I am.
Sober.
Happy.
I'm found.
Was blind, but now I see.
Every day, shattered lives are restored thanks to the goods you donate to the Salvation Army.
It's the time of the year when we pick winners, like Team Davis, who came out on top with an outstanding mortgage loan from AOD Federal Credit Union. Score big with AODFCU. For more information, call or visit AODFCU.com today. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender. It's the time of the year when we pick winners, like Team Gray, who upped their game with a low-rate auto loan from AOD Federal Credit Union. Score big with AODFCU. For more information, call or visit AODFCU.com today. Federally insured by NCUA.
I have my own lawn care service. One day I had some blades that was bent.
I was probably here for 5 minutes and they had me back on the road going.
It helps me make more money simply because it's a more dependable machine. And side-by-side comparisons, people want to say they're better, but I've driven them and Toro is the best.
Hey folks, come see us at Foothills Tractor. We're your one-stop shop for anything you need. Locally owned, locally operated, give you the best customer service guaranteed.
Hi, I'm Katina Houston Stroud with Family Links, and this is the Family Tip of the Week. A client once told me, when I was 8 years old, my friend was invited to a neighborhood birthday party and I wasn't. There was ice cream cake and the promise of a pinata. I was devastated. She said, my parents could have asked the neighbors to invite me. They could have sent me along to the party uninvited. They could have even come up with a special afternoon so that I would be distracted during the party, but they didn't do any of those things. My parents let me experience this disappointment without intervening. Sounds cruel, huh? But what her parents did that day was actually very important, and here's why. I speak with parents who go to great lengths to help their children avoid disappointment, stress, and adversity, and I understand this instinct. But by doing so, parents are unintentionally shielding their child from learning opportunities. A child who's been protected from all unhappiness may have trouble dealing with disappointment as a child, and more importantly, as an adult. These same children become adults whose biggest challenge is conflict negotiation. They're often unable to think for themselves, they want instant gratification, and have very low frustration tolerance. Certainly, disappointment is not a pleasant emotion. It feels really bad, in fact, but that doesn't mean it is a bad emotion to be avoided at all costs. To the contrary, disappointment is actually a healthy and positive emotion that plays an essential role in children's emotional, intellectual, and social development. So coping with disappointment is a key to successful, balanced life. Remember, you should view your children's disappointments as positive experiences that prepare them for adulthood. Childhood disappointment is actually a practice lap on the course to adulthood. If you run interference whenever disappointment threatens, you're setting your kids up to run a marathon without ever letting them train for it. For more parenting tips, please contact Family Links at 256-820-5911.
And welcome to this week's edition of Calhoun County's Most Wanted. First up in our lineup this week, Angela Huggins. Miss Huggins, last known to be living in Anniston, she's wanted for a probation violation for obstruction of justice by giving a false ID. And meet Stephen Walker. Mr. Walker, last known to be living in Jacksonville, he's wanted for failure to pay on possession of a controlled substance. Take a look at Danielle Wood. Mr. Wood, last known to be living in Oxford, he's wanted for probation violation on receiving stolen property second. And this is William Roper. Mr. Roper, last known to be living in Anniston, he's wanted for failure to pay on burglary third. We'd like you to meet James Smith. Mr. Smith, last known to be living in Anniston, he's wanted for failure to pay on theft of property second. And this is Timothy Crook. Mr. Crook, last known to be living in Anniston, he's wanted for being a sex offender in violation of the Sex Offender Registration and Notification Act times 3, and on probation violations for the Sex Offender Registration and Notification Act. And last up for the first half of our lineup, Kedrick Elston. Mr. Elston, last known to be living in Oxford, he's wanted for failure to pay for discharging a gun into an occupied building. And that's it for the first half of our lineup. Stay tuned for the second half later in the show.
All right, we are back. We'll have more bad guys for you here in just a few minutes. But right now, John, Calhoun County is going to the dogs.
It is. It's going to the dogs, and we brought a couple of dogs with us today.
Mike and Paul from AM K9, welcome to Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
All right. You guys, everybody knows that we've got dog training going on in Calhoun County. Everybody just about is aware at this point that something's going on there. And most people know, hey, didn't that have something to do with Auburn University? But beyond that, a lot of people don't really realize what's going on with AM K9 in Calhoun County. So we thought we'd have you guys on to let everybody know what's going on and what to expect if they see some of your canines out in public.
Well, we have been out in public quite a bit. Calhoun County has really been over backwards for us. The community has really provided us a great resource to train our dogs off campus. McClellan is where we train our dogs primarily. We began in Florida in 03, moved up here not too long after. And we need to stretch our resources, which Calhoun County has provided for us, includes Auburn University, which Paul will discuss in a minute. But it's been fantastic with the car dealerships, the warehouses, everything for us to get and put our dogs in new space, and challenge them, and the county has just really been tremendous with us. So we're very ecstatic about that.
We've got a lot of resources in the county. Do you ever use the airport now? You know, we have a local airport. You guys could use that.
Right? No, we haven't. We haven't reached out to the airport at this point, but pretty much everybody but the airport we've hit up.
We can work on the airport if you'd like. that's really busy twice a year.
That would be a big help for us because a lot of our teams that we are training are for government agencies, and these dogs and our handlers together as a team are going to end up over in Iraq or Afghanistan working for several of our federal agencies.
Let's talk about the training. What exactly are you training these dogs to do?
That's a good question. What we train them to do is everything from a patrol role, which is you're pretty familiar with in the Sheriff's Department, to more importantly, what we utilize mostly is their detection capabilities. And we specialize in explosive detection. And we also specialize in a vapor wake, which is our partnership that AM Canine has with Auburn University, which a lot of the folks are in the local area are pretty familiar with Auburn and their canine research and detection center. So we do two facets of our business right now.
The vapor wake dogs, we have two of them in the Calhoun County School System. Two of our SROs were trained out there with you guys, and they were the first two vapor wake dogs in the country, I think, that were put in the school systems.
Yes.
What these dogs do is, it's almost like science fiction to a lot of us that don't really understand. We hear what these dogs are being trained to do, and we think there's absolutely no way a dog can do that.
Yeah, a dog can, and it's kind of funny you bring that up. There's a GAO report. You go pull it up, where Department of Defense spent billions, not millions, but billions of dollars on finding out what is the best detection tool out there. It was a 5-year study, and during that 5 years, they came back to, it's the dog.
Wow.
Billions spent to multiple companies to do this, and it came back to being the dog again. Dogs are incredible.
How are dogs able to find things that we can't find with million-dollar pieces of equipment?
That's a good question. I was recently part of a project where we had a dog in a lab, and they were measuring a certain substance to see how low the dog was getting down to. And I trained a dog to detect down to 0.5 nanograms per minute, which I'm not a mathematician, I'm just a dog trainer, so forgive me. I was told that was 0.5 of a billionth of a gram, and that was if the dog's nose was in that tube for a minute. The dog's nose was in the tube for about 2 seconds. So the scientists in the study were kind of high-fiving and shaking their heads saying that's absolutely incredible. And, you know, to me, it's not a big deal. We see it every day. They said that by their mathematical calculations that the dog was detecting lower than one parts per quadrillionth, which is that's as low as any laboratory equipment can go. So they're saying that our dog's noses are more sensitive than any man-made tool we have.
Let's put that into terms that we can all relate to, because that big numbers like that, we just can't fathom them, really.
Right.
But we understand lives saved.
Yes.
How is this impacting our lives and our safety?
Well, let me tell you this. Our dogs are our tool as well. We can take them anywhere in the world. They're mobile. We can go from point A to point B quickly. Equipment. Heavy equipment that can potentially get down as low as a dog. You have to pack it up. It's very large, cumbersome, etc. It takes a great deal of time, effort, and money to get it from point A to point B. A dog is, again, mobile, rides with us, can jump in the back of a car, in the car with us, get on an aircraft with us, and fly from here to Afghanistan or Iraq, where we take our dogs to. And providing protection for the infrastructure of the U.S. embassies and other places overseas, and our U.S. personnel overseas. That's what a dog does and can do presently.
Mm. All right, well, we need to take a quick break, but when we come back, can we meet one of the dogs?
You bet.
Sure.
Awesome. We will have another guest joining us when we return on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
Ready for a new ride? Get ready for Rig. I'm Rig A. Marole, and I am ready with all the fancy jargon, made-up expenses, marketing gimmicks, and flat-out lies that you've come to expect when you go car shopping. You want to pay way too much for a piece of junk like this? Get a load of me. Rig a Marole at your neighborhood used car dealer. I'll have you marolling off this lot in your new vehicle.
I'm Marty Boyles, and I guarantee no rigmarole here at Jacksonville Auto Sales. Just good cars and trucks at fair prices. We're in Jacksonville across from Walmart, or find us on the web at jascars.com. Remember, Jacksonville Auto Sales, home of the no rigmarole deal.
I have my own lawn care service. One day I had some blades that was bent. I was probably here for 5 minutes, and they had me back on the road going.
It helps me make more money simply because it's a more dependable machine. And side-by-side comparisons, people want to say they're better, but I've driven them, and Toro is the best.
Hey, folks, come see us at Foothills Tractor. We're your one-stop shop for anything you need. Locally owned, locally operated, give you the best customer service guaranteed.
Grace.
How sweet the sound that saved
a crackhead,
drug addict, alcoholic,
meth freak,
a wretch
like me.
I once was
homeless,
broken, sad,
just lost.
But now I am
sober,
happy.
I'm found.
Was blind, but now I see.
Every day, shattered lives are restored thanks to the goods you donate to the Salvation Army.
And welcome to the second half of our lineup. First up, this half, Katrina Brooks. Miss Brooks, last known to be living in Anniston, she's wanted for a probation violation on aggravated cruelty to animals. Take a look at Chad Stanley. Mr. Stanley, last known to be living in East Oboga, he's wanted for failure to appear on prescription drugs, illegal possession thereof. And meet Christy Lindsay. Miss Lindsay, last known to be living in Lincoln, she's wanted on a probation violation for possession of a controlled substance. And this is Garrett Heathcock. Mr. Heathcock, last known to be living in Ohatchee, he's wanted on failure to appear for domestic violence, third assault. We'd like you to meet Stanley Thomas. Mr. Thomas, last known to be living in Anniston, he's wanted for failure to pay on possession of a controlled substance. And last up in our lineup this week, Sandra Addison. Miss Addison, last known to be living in Anniston, she's wanted for failure to pay on theft of property first. And that's it for our lineup this week. If you know the whereabouts of any of these folks, please give us a call at Crime Stoppers, 256-238-1414.
All right, we are back on Calhoun County's Most Wanted. We've been talking with Paul and Mike from AMK9, and now another guest joining us. Tell us about Lucy here.
This is Lucy. She's a 9-year-old Belgian Malinois. I like to say she's retired.
You don't talk about a girl's age.
Oops, sorry. I'm always in trouble.
You're not going to tell us how much she weighs now, are you?
Well, she's very, very thin.
So she's been around for a little while. She's got some experience. Can you tell us some of the things that Lucy has done?
Sure. Lucy has been a patrol explosive detection dog her whole career. I partnered up with Lucy when she was about 13 weeks old and started the training process. She's been to Afghanistan and done some great work for our country as my partner. And most recently, she assisted in helping Coach Gross find his mother. So she's,
thank you,
she's
Lucy.
She's a pretty amazing dog.
And to you as well.
Thank you.
I know that was not a fun task.
No, sir, but it's, you know, it's an important one.
Absolutely. Yeah. So Lucy, of course, is fully trained.
Yes,
we're
sir.
Not going to see her out in the community doing training exercises like you do with the dogs that you are training, but we will see dogs occasionally if we're down shopping at the mall or at a warehouse or somewhere at a car dealership. What should we do as just Joe Public when we see AMK9 out with a dog training?
I think the best thing that I like to see people is a lot of people are afraid to talk to us. Don't be afraid to come over and say hello. All of our dogs are tested to make sure that they're social and they're safe. Mm-hmm. You're not going to interfere with what we're doing. you have a question, come on over and introduce yourself and say hello. Interact with us. Interact with the dogs. That's why we train out in public.
So it's not like a service dog for someone that is out there, an individual with their dog. You're not supposed to approach the dog, but with these, it's okay to have some interaction with them?
Yeah, it's okay to have interaction with a handler and the dog if the handler says it's okay to interact with the dog. But don't be afraid to interact with the handler. Mm-hmm. And 9 times out of 10, we'll let you say hello.
Now, what if I'm carrying something in my pocket and I interact with the dog?
Well, it depends upon what you're carrying in your pocket, if you can share it or not. You might want to choose wisely if you have things you shouldn't have, because these dogs are trained to detect those things.
So this is something that Calhoun County is having an impact on safety and security worldwide.
Worldwide.
A tremendous impact. And here's how Calhoun County's helped us, our company, and Auburn University out tremendously, is by allowing us to take these dogs out into the real world, which is where they're going to work. Mm-hmm. We can't say at a training facility that I'm putting my 100% stamp certifying that this dog is going to be able to work in the real world, under normal real distractions, or the abnormal distractions and curveballs that get thrown at us when we do go to the mall, or when I do go to Cooper Chevrolet, or Oxford Lumber, or Lowe's. Lowe's in Anniston is a huge supporter of our program. So I never know what these dogs are going to be confronted with, mm-hmm. from an overly excited child to an automobile accident when we're in the parking lot, training with the dogs, searching with the dogs.
And John, tell us about the dogs that we have working in Calhoun County.
Well, we have at the sheriff's office, we have two patrol dogs that one will detect people, and the other will detect, I think, some drugs. And then we've got the vapor wake dogs in the schools, which detect weapons or explosives.
Yes, sir.
And they are unique because we were the first school system, and I don't know how many other school systems have those dogs, but we were the first in the country to get them, and they're very useful, very useful.
And you probably get the questions all the time from people in the public saying, hey, I just got this dog, can you help me? But that's not what you guys do, is it?
No.
No, sir. That is probably one of the most asked questions I get. Help, please. this is a full-time job for us, just doing training these dogs to serve really our country.
Mm-hmm. Before a handler ever gets a dog, is assigned to a dog as a partner, the dogs go through about 12 weeks of training. That's a lot, 3 months before it's handed to a handler. Then they have additional training based on requirements, and based on where they're going will determine how long that training will last as a team.
My first job, I walked in, they said, here are the turntables, here's the microphone switch, go.
I like that.
3 months of training for a dog.
Yeah, just for the dog. And then when they're teamed up with a handler, at that point there's additional training that goes on. So it's a very long process. About 16 weeks is what it takes before we turn it out outside and send them off to Afghanistan or Iraq or somewhere. And with sustainment training, maintenance training, all those type of things, certifications. We have third-party certifications for the majority, if not all, of our dogs. It's quite intense.
Awesome. Well, we could hang out with you guys and Lucy for all day, but we're about out of time. If anybody does have any questions about AMK9, how can they contact you?
Really, you can come out to our facility if you'd like on the fort and come introduce yourself. We don't mind giving people tours and we're proud of what we do. And we're proud of the support that our community gives us, and the least we could do is give back a little bit and give them a tour.
Just don't expect training.
No, but amk9.com. Yeah. That's our website. Yes. Just go there. We can make contact with us anytime.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. Lucy, nice to meet you.
Say bye, Lucy.
Right. We will be right back on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
It's the time of the year when we pick winners, like Team Davis, who came out on top with an outstanding mortgage loan from AOD Federal Credit Union. Score big with AODFCU. For more information, call or visit AODFCU.com today. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender. It's the time of the year when we pick winners, like Team Gray, who upped their game with a low-rate auto loan from AOD Federal Credit Union. Score big with AODFCU. For more information, call or visit AODFCU.com today. Federally insured by NCUA.
I have my own lawn care service. One day I had some blades that was bent. I was probably here for 5 minutes, and they have me back on the road going.
It helps me make more money simply because it's a more dependable machine. And side-by-side comparisons, people want to say they're better, but I've driven them and Toro is the best.
Hey folks, come see us at Foothills Tractor. We're your one-stop shop for anything you need. Locally owned, locally operated, give you the best customer service guaranteed.
The Ford brand has always brought you impressive style and legendary quality. And Sonny King Ford brings you the lowest price and the largest inventory, new or pre-owned. The new 2015 F-150 gets the best gas mileage of any truck without giving up its powerful towing capacity. The iconic new 2015 Mustang with its classic pony car looks and hunkered down stance preserves a legacy that defines American motoring. For over 93 years, Sonny King Ford for the best cars and best price.
And welcome to the Crime Stoppers portion of our show, where we ask you to help our investigators with these cases. First up on your caseload, on November 7th, a motor was stolen from a concrete mixer on Stadium Drive in Alexandria. And sometime between December 4th and December 8th, this residence was burglarized on Wellington Road in Wellington. Electronics and jewelry were stolen from that location. And sometime on December 11th, a residence on Mount View Road was burglarized. Now, nothing was reported taken at this time. Sometime on December 15th, a utility trailer was stolen from a residence on Red Road 55 in Anniston. Surveillance cameras show a small blue pickup truck leaving the residence with the trailer. And sometime between December 1st and December 15th, at Huron Valley Steel on Highway 144 in Alexandria was burglarized. Electrical components were stolen from that location. And on December 15th, a barn was burglarized and a vehicle was broken into on Earl Roberts Road in Anniston. No items were reported stolen. And on December 14th, the residence was burglarized on Dripping Rock Road in Piedmont. Firearms, electronics, and medication stolen from that location. And last up on your caseload this week, on December 18th, the vehicle was broken into on White Plains Road in Anniston. They got away with a wallet. If you know anything about these cases, and we hope you do, please give Crime Stoppers a call at 256-238-1414. Remember, we want your information and not your name.
Stupid! You're so stupid!
All right, time for our crazy criminal of the week. And John, when people are arrested, if they've got special markings like tattoos and such, you'll often document those, won't you? Take pictures.
We do.
And keep those in the
absolutely.
Record.
Absolutely. And keep it in our system when they come in the jail, and it's helped identify a lot of people.
You see a lot of interesting tattoos, I'm sure.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Some that we probably can't talk about on television.
Right.
And then some that are, you know, nice mom tattoo or somebody's the name of their mom, right?
Of course.
Well, Thomas Pinson is our crazy criminal this week, and there he is. And if he took his shirt off there, you'd be able to see that he's got a nice tattoo on his chest with his mother's name and a rose. He loves his mom.
Yes.
They documented that tattoo with a picture of it when they were arresting him for a domestic violence against his mother.
Oh, dear. That's a rose by any other name.
You know, if you love her enough to get a tattoo on your chest, try not to hit her. Is that appropriate to
that
say?
That would be appropriate. If you're really going to commit to putting ink on your skin.
Really try not to hit her whether you love her or not. But
Yeah. That's too bad.
Yeah.
His poor mother. She must be very
she's
proud.
She's going to take that tattoo off herself. She's going to remove it for you, Thomas, when you get out. All right. That's all the time that we have for this week. We will be looking for you again next week, but hopefully not in the lineup. We might have some help from Lucy.
We might have some help from Lucy.
Calhoun County's most wanted. Thank you.